Okay, so we're going to talk about the very important business of finding the LCD, that is the least common denominator, of rational expressions. Now remember, a rational expression is basically just a fancy fraction. That is a fraction that has polynomials in the numerator and the denominator. So what we're going to do is we're first going to find the LCD for these two regular fractions and then see how that technique carries over to rational expressions. So remember what we do. To find the LCD of these two fractions, we simply take the two denominators, in this case 24 and 18, and we write them off to the side, like so. And then you find the prime factorization of each number. So 24, for example, can be written as 4 times 6, and 4 is 2 times 2, and 6 is 2 times 3. Okay, and at this stage, those are all prime, right? So I'm finished for the 24. For the 18, likewise. So 18 is 2 times 9, and 2 is prime, so we just bring it down, and 9 is 3 times 3. Okay, now at this stage, you want to build the LCD. So I'm going to write the letters LCD, and here's how you do it, recall. You look at the two prime factorizations, and you start with the lowest prime, in this case, number that you see. So the lowest prime number I see is a 2, and you compare the number of 2s that each number has. This number has 3 2s, and this number over here has 1 2. When you make that comparison, you simply write down the number of 2s you see for the number that has the most of them. Like for example, 24 has 3 2s, and 18 has 1 2. And so I say, hey, when I compare those two, this one has the most number of twos, so I write down this number of twos. Two, two, two. I wrote down three twos, right? I didn't write down four. I compared and I went with the one that had the most. And then I go on to threes. Okay, who has more threes? Well, the 24 has one three, the 18 has two threes, so I go with the 18's threes. So I write down a three and a three. Now the number that you get when you multiply all these numbers together, that's your LCD. So let's see, 2 times 2 times 2 is 8, and then 3 times 3 is 9, so 8 times 9 is 72. So that would be my answer to this question, right? 72 is the LCD. Now it's very important to understand what that number is. It's the smallest number that both 24 and 18 go into evenly. And so what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to check it. Because there's something I want to show you in a moment that the check will illustrate for us in a second. So let me go ahead and check this. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to check that both 24 and 18 go into the 72, okay? So I'm going to take the 72 and I'm going to first divide it by 24, and then I'm going to take the 72 and I'm going to divide it by 18. Right? Theoretically, both the 24 and the 18 should go in evenly. Let's see, 24 does go into 72. It's going to be a 3 over 1. And for the 18, it's going to be a 4 over 1. Now, do you see how there's a 1 in the denominator right there? That is the indicator that 24 and 18 both went in evenly into the 72, okay? So that 1 in the denominator, that is complete cancellation in the denominator, that's your indicator that it goes in evenly. That's a very important observation for us, okay? Now, of course, you know 3 over 1 can be reduced to 3, and 4 over 1 can be reduced to just 4, okay? But you're looking to get complete cancellation in the denominator. Okay, let's go ahead and carry this thought process over for rational expressions. Okay, so here we have, remember, all a rational expression is basically a complicated fraction. That is fractions where the denominators are polynomials, but the same logic carries over. You simply take the two denominators, right? We want to find the LCD. So you simply take the two denominators, 15x to the fourth, y squared, and then you take the other one, just like before. So it's going to be 20x cubed y squared. And then you factor these. Well, 15 we know is 3 times 5. Now, x to the fourth is simply x times x times x times x times x, right? That is four x's. So you can just leave it as x to the fourth. We know this means x times x times x times x. Y squared is y multiplied by itself twice, so we'll just leave it like that. The 20 over here is, well, 4 times 5. And then x cubed we'll just leave as x cubed, and y squared we'll leave as y squared. Now, 4 can be reduced further, or factored further, right? 2 times 2. And then the 5 will bring down, and the x cubed we'll just leave as it is, and the y squared we'll leave it like that as well. Okay, now the time to build the LCD. So now what you do is you go through and you think about prime numbers and prime polynomials. So let's start with the numbers. It's an issue of comparison. So I start with twos. How many twos does this have? Zero. This has two twos, and you compare and you say, okay, we'll go with your twos, you have the most. So we write down two twos. And then we move on to threes. Well, 1 3 versus no threes, so we go with 1 3. Now, whenever there's a tie, like for the fives here, you do a comparison, and if they tie, you simply go with either one of them. So for example, 1 5 and 1 5, so we'll go with your five, for example. The point is that you're always writing down the maximum number that you see, and if it's a tie, you simply write down the maximum number that they're tied at. Okay, so 1 5. Now, as far as the x's are concerned, remember, this has 4 x's, and this has 3 x's, okay? And it's a comparison. Who has more x's? This one does, and so we'll go with your x's. That is 4 factors of x. And then you go on to the y's. 2 y's and 2 y's. Once again, it's a tie, so we're going to go with simply 2 y's, okay? Just like you pick the maximum number of 2's, you also pick the maximum number of x's and the maximum number of y's, okay? So the point is that what carries, the logic that carries with, the logic that carries you forward with the numbers also carries you forward with the polynomials. And then finally what you do is you multiply what you've got, which is, well, it's going to be, let's see, 5 times 2 is 10, and then times 2 times 3 is 6. So we've got 60, right? X to the fourth y squared. And that would be your answer. Now, I'm going to check it so that you can see what it looks like when polynomials go evenly into other polynomials. So over here, let's write our check. So theoretically, these two denominators should go evenly into this, right? So I should be able to take 60 x to the fourth y squared and divide it by, well, 15 x to the fourth y squared. And then the same thing with the other one, right? I should be able to take 60 x to the fourth y squared and divide it by 20 x cubed y squared. Okay, in the first one, what happens? 15 goes evenly into 60 and I get 4. X to the fourths, well, those both cancel, right? So they're gone. And same with the y squareds. So notice how I just get 4 over 1. The fact that we have a 1 right here tells us that 15x to the 4th y squared goes evenly into that numerator, and that is the important point. And for the next one, what do we get? Well, 20 goes into 60, it's going to be 3 times. Now x cubed goes into x to the 4th, and I still have an x in the numerator. Y squareds cancel, but notice that I have a 1 again in the denominator. So you don't have to have a number in the numerator. You can still have polynomials, okay? But what matters is that you have a 1 in the denominator. And that, again, is an indicator to you that they go, or both of these, well, individually, they go, these two denominators go into the 60x to the 4th y squared evenly. Okay, that's what the 1 in the denominator is telling you. Okay, let's try another one like that just to make sure we've got the hang of this. And we'll see some more complicated denominators as well. Okay, so find the LCD for these two. So once again, you take the denominators. So it's going to be 5x squared minus 30x. And the next one's going to be x squared minus 36. And we factor these these expressions. So this is going to be, well, 5x times x minus 6. Now at this stage, notice how these are prime. 5 is a prime, x is a prime, and x minus 6 is a prime. I can't factor any of these further. So this one is all factored into primes. For the next one, how are we going to factor that? Well, it's going to be x plus 6 times x minus 6. So once again, prime polynomials, right? Notice how I got a product, right? I'm multiplying two things together. And the first one is the prime polynomial x plus 6, and the second one is the prime polynomial x minus 6. Now it's time to build your LCD. So once again, we start with numbers. So the only number I see here as a factor is 5. So 1, 5 versus 0, 5. Let's go for the 1, 5. Now I compare x's. 1x, no x's. Now you might say, wait a minute, I see two x's right there. When I say no x's, I mean no x's as factors. X plus 6 is a factor and x minus 6 is a factor, but plain old x is not a factor the way it is over here. X is being multiplied by something over here. X is not being multiplied by anything over here. X plus 6 is, but that's not the same as plain old x. So it's 1x versus no x's, so I put in 1x. Now we go on to x minus 6's. 1x minus 6, 1x minus 6, so I put in one single x minus 6. Know that is 0x plus 6's versus 1x plus 6, so we're going to need 1x plus 6. Okay, so remember we have 1x minus 6 because it was a tie, right? 1x minus 6, 1x minus 6, and we go with the maximum. In this case, it's a tie, so we just go with the single x minus 6. Okay, now, this would be your answer. This is your LCD. Now you might say, shouldn't I multiply these together? Typically when we have polynomials, we don't. Okay, so this, you can stop here. Now I want to show you that both of these denominators do indeed go evenly into the LCD. That is, I want to show you the check so you can see once again what it means to be an LCD. So you take it, right? So you take the 5x times x minus 6 times x plus 6. First you divide it by 5x squared minus 30x. And then you take the same thing, that is 5x, x minus 6 times x plus 6, and you divide it by the other denominator, which is x squared minus 36. Okay, so now, it's not obvious right now the cancellation I'm going to get, but remember, we know how to factor this 5x squared minus 36, minus 30x. We did it over here. So I'm going to replace this with its factored form over there. The numerator is going to remain the same. So 5x times x minus 6 times x plus 6, but that denominator can now be written as 5x times x minus 6. Let's do the same thing over here. So 5x, x minus 6, x plus 6, that remains the same. That denominator, of course, we know how to factor it, right? It's x plus 6 times x minus 6. And now, of course, we can do some cancellation. So here, the 5x and the 5x, they completely cancel, right? X minus 6, x minus 6. Lo and behold, I have a 1 left in the denominator. So I get x plus 6 over 1. And what does that 1 mean to us again? It means the polynomial in the denominator went evenly into the polynomial in the numerator. Okay? Same thing for the next one. The x plus 6 cancels with the x plus 6, x minus 6 with the x minus 6, and we get 5x over 1, again representing the fact that we had even division. Okay, so we say it goes in evenly. Okay, the 1 is the indicator to us. Now, if you think you found an LCD and you can't do this, that is, you can't completely cancel, that is, you have something left in the denominator other than 1 after you do the division, then you did not find a common multiple. Okay, the denominators that you start with have to go evenly into this. Okay, so we have a lot of important uses for the LCD for rational expressions. That includes adding and subtracting, Okay? We're going to be adding and subtracting rational expressions, and we're also going to be simplifying. Well, simplifying what we call complex fractions. Actually, there's one more after this even. Simplifying complex fractions, and we're also going to be solving rational, solving equations with rational expressions. Solving rational expression equations. Okay, these are all things that are very important that hinge upon our ability to find the LCD of rational expressions. Okay, until next time.